What's going on, guys? I'm Chris, and today I'm going to be talking about my top 10 favorite film composers of all time. Now, there's a ton of great movie scores out there and composers in general, so it was really hard for me to sit down and pick just 10. The way that this is going to work is I'm going to go through each pick, and I'm going to give the composer as well as my favorite movie score that the composer scored. So it's going to be a lot of me saying the word score, so just brace yourself for that. But I'm excited to get right into it, and definitely consider hitting the like button and comment down below who your favorite film score composers of all time are. So coming in at number 10 for me is James Horner, who notably scored movies like Braveheart, Titanic, and Apollo 13. And my favorite film score that he composed has to be for Braveheart, simply because of the score that accompanies the freedom speech that William Wallace gives before a crucial battle in the movie.
They may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom!
That has always stuck out to me, and it's a moment that gives me chills, largely in part to the score, but James Horner's work all around is just super solid. Coming in at number 9 for me is Howard Shore, who is very famous for scoring all of the Lord of the Rings and Hobbit films. He did a fantastic job with those, and I would have to say that is also my favorite score that he's ever done. There are various beats of music throughout there that are just so great. They accompany the scene so well, especially in Return of the King when Aragorn says, the score in that scene just elevates it to a whole nother level, and Concerning Hobbits is another score that I just love when they're in the Shire. It's very calm and fits the atmosphere perfectly, but the Lord of the Rings score all around is something that I think it's well known for, as well as the fantastic movies, but Howard Shore's score here is phenomenal. He also scored movies like Seven and Silence of the Lambs, so he has a ton of experience in this field. Coming in at number 8 for me is Danny Elfman, who just might be the king of superhero scores, as he did Sam Raimi's Spider-Man trilogy. He scored those films, and he also did the Tim Burton Batman films, and those two superhero scores are iconic in my eyes. I grew up watching the Raimi trilogy, and of course I played the Lego Batman game, and Elfman's score accompanied that game. He just has this unique flair to him that feels comic book-esque when you listen to his music, especially the Batman theme, which is probably the most iconic Batman theme that exists in my opinion, but I have to say that Sam Raimi's Spider-Man trilogy, the score for those movies has to be my favorite from Danny Elfman. So for number 7, I'm throwing it back a little. I'm going with Bernard Herrmann, who is known for scoring Taxi Driver, but especially Psycho and a lot of other Alfred Hitchcock works such as North by Northwest and Vertigo. The score for Psycho is essentially a character in and of itself, especially in the shower scene. It is one of the most chilling moments in cinematic history, but I think my favorite from him besides Psycho has to be Thank God for the Rain. That's the name of a track on the Taxi Driver soundtrack, and it just fits that gritty and grimy New York City nighttime feel so perfectly, as the score will play when Robert De Niro's character is just driving through New York at night. Kind of in a scummy area of New York City with a lot of shady people getting in his car at night. Coming in at number 6 for me are some young guns when it comes to the movie score industry, and that is Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross, who scored The Social Network, Gone Girl, and Mid-90s. All three are fantastic scores. Bar none, my favorite score from them has to be the Academy Award winning score for The Social Network. The score in this movie fits the pace of the movie so well. There's a track called In Motion that takes place early on in the movie when Mark Zuckerberg and Eduardo are going through their plan, and you see Mark Zuckerberg's mind at work, and it fits this montage in a way very, very well. I think that In Motion is one of my favorite scores ever, actually.
Yeah, it's on. I'm not gonna do the farm animals, but I like the idea of comparing two people together. It gives the whole thing a very Turing feel, since people's ratings of the pictures will be more implicit than, say, choosing a number to represent each person's hotness like they do on hotornot.com.
The music that just plays throughout the movie, especially towards the end in the big confrontation scene, it's mellow in a sense, but it also blends it with this techno genre so well, and it makes for one of the most unique scores in a movie. Like I said about the Psycho score, the Social Network score really does fit the movie and acts as a character in a way. So before I give my top 5, definitely consider hitting the like button, and like I said at the beginning, comment comment down below who your favorite film composers of all time are, because there are so many great ones. But coming in at number five for me is Thomas Newman, who somehow has never won an Academy Award. It is insane to me. He has scored movies like American Beauty, Finding Nemo, 1917 from last year, and of course The Shawshank Redemption. This is one of the greatest composers of all time, without a doubt, and I think that my favorite score by him might just be American Beauty. I like the piano and how it just fits that movie so well.
My name is Lester Burnham.
It deals with the dysfunction in a family, and it fits it so perfectly. The main American Beauty theme gives me chills every time I hear it. But Finding Nemo, one of Pixar's best movies, has another fantastic score. His scores very much follow the tone and feel of the movie and guide the viewer through the movie audibly. Coming in at number four for me is Michael Giacchino, who has done the MCU Spider-Man movie, Star Trek Into Darkness, Mission Impossible 3 and 4, and of course The Incredibles and Up. He actually won an Academy Award for his work scoring the film Up, one of Pixar's best movies. It's in my top three, and the track Married Life, it brings me to tears every time I listen to it. It gives me chills at the same time because that score accompanies the opening of Up, which is infamous for making everyone cry. But Married Life, it's so romantic, and it makes you feel something inside. It makes you think of your loved ones and your relationships you have with people. I'm so happy he won the Oscar, and he's one of my favorite working composers today. Coming in at number three is Alan Silvestri, who has done Forrest Gump, Captain America the First Avenger, The Avengers, and Avengers Endgame, and of course, Back to the Future. Alan Silvestri, in my opinion, is one of the more underrated composers today when it comes to Academy Award nominations. I have no idea how he was not nominated for his work on Avengers Endgame, because Portals is one of my favorite scores of all time, and it fits one of my favorite scenes of all time, but I think that the most iconic score from Alan Silvestri, besides the Avengers theme, has to be Back to the Future. It accompanies the adventure of that movie so well, and it fits the urgency of the movie as you just feel in that final scene when Marty has to go 88 miles an hour to get back to the future. The score in that enhances it to the next level, and I just love his scores on almost every movie that he does. While I thoroughly enjoy everyone that I've talked about so far, my top two are essentially kings of scores, in my opinion, and on their own level. And very hard for me to differentiate the two. They're amazing composers, but number two for me is Hans Zimmer, who is known for his work on Man of Steel, Inception, Interstellar, Gladiator, and of course The Lion King. What a beautiful score for that movie. It's hard for me to pinpoint one Hans Zimmer score that I love the most. I think Time from the movie Inception, which plays towards the end of the film, is one of my all-time favorites. I listen to that if I'm writing or doing schoolwork or just really trying to focus. I think it's one of the best pieces of music ever put to the screen. And same with Stay from Interstellar. It accompanies the movie so well. His work with Christopher Nolan is really what sets him apart. Man of Steel is one of those tracks that I listen to when I'm working out, and it makes me just want to sprint and give it my all. Hans Zimmer is the king, in my opinion, of these uplifting and inspirational slash motivational scores, while also delivering these cool, calm, relaxed scores that can really put you at ease. But coming in at number one, if you haven't guessed by now, is John Williams himself, from Star Wars to Jaws, Jurassic Park, all of it. This man can do no wrong, in my opinion. He's done Harry Potter, Home Alone, Raiders of the Lost Ark, and the Indiana Jones films. He has the most iconic scores across the board, in my opinion. He's worked so many times with Steven Spielberg, and it is insanely hard for me to pick one, whether it's the opening crawl Star Wars music, the main title, or the Indiana Jones theme, or the Jaws theme, or Jurassic Park. I literally can't just pinpoint one. He's done it all, and I have most of his songs on my music scores playlist. I should just make a John Williams playlist in and of itself. He's the reason that all of these fantastic franchises are epic and are known the way they are. It's not just the direction that makes these movies great, it's the scores. So that's a wrap for my top 10 favorite film composers of all time video. I hope you all enjoyed. Definitely comment down below who yours are, because I know that I didn't get to include every composer and there's a lot that I had to leave off the list, but I would be interested in having a conversation with you down below. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel. It would mean the world. The support lately has really just meant so much, and just I love seeing the channel grow and the community grow. I also have the Film Saga podcast now with my great friend Trevor over at Film Geeks. Definitely subscribe to his channel and check out that podcast. We have our own Instagram at the Film Saga podcast, where we'll be engaging with the community, posting polls regarding a new segment on the podcast. So definitely head over to Instagram and check that out. And every Monday, be on the lookout for a new episode of the podcast. Stay tuned for new videos coming soon, collabs, live streams, all that good stuff. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.